I'm NSAP Purnima, your social sciences teacher. Welcome to social sciences class, children. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, some new topics. Do you have any idea, children? What is the next lesson? Yes, I will tell you what is the next lesson. Today, let us discuss about very interesting topic. What is the topic, you know, children? See, lesson 4, our dresses. Children, generally for any festival or birthday, what are you going to buy, children? Yes, sweets, chocolates, fruits, and most importantly, a new dress, right? It gives us an immense happiness to buy and put on a new dress. You really feel special on a special occasion. But did you observe the dresses in your family? You might like to wear a jeans, kurta, ghagra, depending on the event. Your mother mostly preferred to wear sari and salwars, but your grandmother only wears saris, isn't it? So, depending on age, tradition, and occasion, we select or wear a particular dress. India is a land of traditions. The same dress, that is sari, is worn by different people in different styles because they live in different states. Let us know further, children. India is a land of colorful dresses. Visit any place and you will see the woman wearing a variety of dresses like skirt, jeans, trousers, sari, salwar kameez, ghagra, lungi, etc. The men can be seen in kurta pajamas, lungi, dhoti. Where is the dhoti? Dhoti, see, children, where it is? Here. Tahmat, jeans or trousers. In some places, you will find people wearing warm woolen clothes, and in other places, people may be wearing cool cotton clothes. In the cold climate of Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, northern India, children, northern Indian states, northern states of India, the climate is very cold. So, the people of Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, those people wear warm woolen clothes, and southern Indian states means Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, these people wearing cool cotton dresses. Why, children? Why is there such a variety in dresses? Do you have any idea? Why there is a such variety in dresses? One reason for the variety is the climate, and the other reason is the culture and tradition of the people. These are cool cotton clothes, these are woolen clothes, children. In hot and humid climate of Tamil Nadu and Kerala, people wear cool cotton clothes, and the men mostly wear lungi and cotton shirts and the women wear sarees or lungi with a blouse. The people living in the cold climate of Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh wear thick woolen clothes to keep themselves warm. The men wear caps and the women wear colorful scarves or shawls to protect their heads from the chilly winds. See children, in hot and humid climate of Tamil Nadu and Kerala, people wear cool cotton clothes. The men mostly wear lungi and cotton shirts and the women wear sarees or lungi with a blouse. The people living in the cold climate of Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh wear thick woolen clothes to keep themselves warm. The men wear caps and the women wear colorful scarves or shawls to protect their heads from the chilly winds. The dresses of women as well as the men are made up of different types of materials like cotton, silk, wool, nylon, rayon, etc. And in this, cotton, silk and wool are natural fibers. Nylon and polyester are man-made fibers. Do you understand, children? Cotton, silk and wool are natural fibers. Nylon and polyester are man-made fibers. Children, the dresses of women as well as the men are made up of different types of materials like cotton, silk, wool, nylon, rayon, etc. The types of material people choose for their dresses depends upon the climate. In areas of high temperature, cotton and linen fabrics are worn, and in cold climate, people mostly use silk and woolen materials. Children, this is cotton. Cotton comes from cotton plants. Silk comes from silkworms. And wool comes from the fur of animals like sheep, yak, etc. Cotton comes from cotton plant, silk from silkworm, and wool from fur of animals like sheep, yak, etc. Understand, children? See, children, the culture and tradition of an area also affect our dress. If you go to Hyderabad or Lucknow, you will find some Muslim women wearing burqa. This is burqa, children. It is a long black or dark colored cloak. In Kashmir, men as well as women wear a loose long robe known as firan. This is firan, children. The women from Assam wear mekhla chadar. This is their traditional dress, children. Assam traditional dress, mekhla chadar. And our cute girl's favorite dress, Rajasthani women wear ghagra choli. Not only Rajasthani women, children, in our class, in our school, in our surroundings, neighbors, relatives, all the cute girls like to wear ghagra choli on special occasions, isn't it? Girls like to wear this ghagra choli on special occasions. And when we'll come to the boys, boys like to wear kutta paijama, nice jean pant and a good looking t-shirt for special occasions. Isn't it, children? Now, follow the assignment, children. First one, cotton, silk and wool are dash fibers. In areas of high temperature, dash and dash fabrics are worn. In Kashmir, men as well as women wear dash. Rajasthani women wear dash. The dresses of the people depend on the dash of a place. That's all for today, children. We will meet in the next session. Thank you.